there we go, bringing you along this journey toward my first marathon. And yes, it starts now. 6 months from now, hopefully, I will be running a marathon. And it starts in the gym for me with light stretching, core work, a little bit of lifting. All that stretching machine is just kicking my butt. But I already made a little progress from 2 days ago. And then the pool. I'm really excited. And actually, if you have any tips for the pool, let me know. But I'm really excited to take better care of my body as training increases, as mileage increases, the volume of running mixed with speed work. I know I'm gonna have to do better in 2019, taking care of, as the I think everyone in Europe calls it, the niggles, those little aches and pains, as we say here in America. Like those little niggles, they can really come back to bite you if you don't take care of yourself. So anyway, the pool is gonna be key for that in 2019. I'm excited to just stay as nimble as possible. Okay, 2019, here we go, the training schedule. First of all, I said this 2 days ago. First tip for planning out your racing schedule, and many of you probably already do this naturally. It's pretty basic, but it's a good reminder. Know your why. Know your why. Why are you racing this particular race? Maybe it's to challenge yourself to go from a 10K to a half marathon. Maybe it's to inspire yourself to lose a little weight, huh? Like to get a little more fit, a little more lean. Maybe it's to raise money for a charity. Maybe it's to complete your first marathon. Right here, that's me. Maybe it's to see a new place of the world that has a beautiful marathon distance race or an ultra race, and you're gonna travel, you know, around the world to this location to experience a new culture. So, tip number one, know your why, and it's really important to have a really solid why. Point number one, tip number one, before you plan your 2019 training schedule, you cannot plan a training schedule if you do not know your peak races, all right? I am starting to hone in. Actually, I'll just call it right now. If I register and I'm accepted, but I think I will be. The Pikes Peak Ascent is August 25th. That'll be my second peak race. It's here in Colorado. It's a half marathon up a 14,000 foot mountain. I'm so excited for it. And then my first marathon probably will be in June. I'm honing in on the Grandma's Marathon in Duluth, Minnesota. We'll see. Again, I have to contact the race director January 1st to see if I can get into the elite field. And I'll talk about why I'm leaning toward that marathon over others. And if I don't get into that marathon, then I will definitely be doing a marathon in the fall, either the CIM out in Sacramento or potentially an East Coast marathon. I'm working on that with someone that I know. So anyway, gotta know your peak races before we can dive into this. And on that note, let's go out to the shed and get down to the details. All right, we're out in the shed. There's so much to cover on this topic of building a training plan for 2019, and this is not a vlog or a video about specific workouts. This is about the macro level, 30,000 foot view, looking down upon my 2019 calendar year with flexibility built in. I want to make that point clear. Like, this is why you saw me inside there researching the marathons, researching the half marathons. By the way, thank you for all the comments a couple days ago about the Grandma's Marathon, which I'm interested in, and then just sharing about half marathons across the United States that are coming up. I haven't registered yet. I'm working on that. But peak races are, like, you have to have those peak races in order to work backward in your training schedule. So that is point number two. Once you have chosen a peak race, which we love peak races as runners because, like, that's where we can strive for PRs, strive for maybe podium finishes, or strive, who knows, maybe even to win prize money, or even just simply, like, to say to yourself, I want to improve my overall health and fitness by 5 to 10% in the new year. Like, anyway, peak races are a beautiful thing. But once you have chosen the peak race, you have the date on the calendar, and then what I like to do is work backward from that date, literally on a physical calendar. And I know this is old school, but this is what I do. I work backward. I count how many weeks do I have until the peak race is going to happen? So then I know in my mind, okay, I have, for example, for grandma's, it's 25 weeks from now, which is a little under 6 months. That's a lot of time. That's good. And then from grandma's to the next peak race for me in 2019, it's the Pikes Peak Ascent, which is 9 weeks. Also pretty good. Not perfect, but pretty good. So once you have your peak races chosen, you can then begin to build your training blocks. And this is point number three. We can't stay at the top of the mountain forever, meaning at our peak level of fitness. Like, our body will break down and you'll get injured or you'll just burn out. And so we need to have valleys and peaks in our training, valleys and peaks. Connected to peak races, connected to the calendar, based upon how many weeks you have to work with, will impact your training block. This is what I like to do. 3 months of aerobic development, 1 month of anaerobic development. So 4 months leading up to a peak race. And this is, if you do the math, 12 divided by 4 is 3. And that's why I love to shoot for 2 to 3 peak races in a calendar year. Now, we can't get into the science behind aerobic versus anaerobic, but I will just say I lean toward more aerobic training versus anaerobic training. And I wish I could get into the details of that, like pH level in our blood and how that impacts our overall body health. Anyway, we're not going to get into that right now, but our aerobic development, especially as half marathon and marathon runners, like, it's so critical. And what is aerobic development? Basically, our body's ability to deliver oxygen to all of our muscles and as through our bloodstream. So anyway, we won't get into the details of that, but that is what I like to do. 3 months of aerobic development. So long running, long, slow running sometimes. Like, it's not too exciting, just getting in the miles. And I will just give you one more detail. When I start my training on January 1st, I will run 15 to 20 miles that first week, which is, you know, not too much. And then I will add 10 miles a week, 10 miles a week, 10 miles a week, until I feel as though my body is reaching that limit of aerobic development where I'm like, okay, I'm getting a little tired here. I don't want to go too far, but I also don't want to, you know, I don't want to hold back either. There's overtraining in running and there's undertraining. Like, you all have probably experienced overtraining. So a lot of you have already shared that with me down in the comments. But what about undertraining, huh? We don't often hear about undertraining. So we got to walk that fine line at times. And so for training block, I like to lean toward 4 months is like the ideal amount of time for me. So that is my overarching training block philosophy. And then for this year, leading up to grandma's, I'm gonna have a mini peak in March, come down a little bit, and then another big peak leading up to grandma's in June. And then I'll come down again, and then go back up for August, come down again, way down, and then maybe a big peak in late 2019 for another marathon. We'll see about that. But that is my overarching kind of wave of 2019 training blocks. And then drilling down just a little bit. And this is a little side tip that I'm just, and this is based a little bit upon your flexibility with your life. And I realize everybody has to work. Many of you have families. Like, it's just a busy world out there. But I would say, don't be afraid to break out of the weekly training cycle. A lot of people do a long run every week, which is awesome. But if your body is starting to bark at you and say, hey, I'm getting a little tired in this training block, I need to back off a little bit, don't be afraid to say, okay, I'm gonna do a long run on Sunday, and then I'm gonna do a long run in 10 days from now, rather than 7 days from now. But of course, it is impacted a little bit by your work schedule, by your life schedule. But if you could squeeze it in maybe at night, especially in the summertime, or maybe early in the morning. But I'm just always a little shocked at how everyone has to get in their long run every single weekend, which is good if you are feeling fresh and healthy. But don't, I guess, like the seven, like who made up the rules that we have to stick to a 7-day training cycle? don't be afraid. Anyway, that's a, like a little tip that I lean toward, especially in the summertime when the days are longer. Breaking out a little bit of that 7-day training cycle and bumping it up usually to like 10 days. So like if there's 30 days in a month, that means you'll have 3 training cycles or 3 weeks, but it's really an extended week of training in 1 month. Does that make sense? And just a couple more points before we wrap up. Back to the calendar. I like this paper calendar because it allows me to see the entire year right in front of me. And I know you can do this electronically, but I prefer to write it out with a pencil. Make sure you have a pencil so you can go back and erase. And rather than set in stone, I'm gonna run 50 miles this week, no matter what. I like to give a range. So usually I do a 10-mile range. So like you just see here, like here's 70 to 80 miles, 80 to 90 miles, 90 to 100 miles. We'll see. But like it's better to, instead of feeling pressure like, oh my gosh, no matter what, I have to hit, you know, 60 miles this week, give yourself a range, and maybe it's a 15 to 20 mile range. I wouldn't recommend anything over that because then you can get maybe a little too relaxed, but definitely don't hesitate to have a range for your mileage. And then you can just go week by week, month by month, building your training schedule. And then once you have your goal mileage laid out, oh, then you start plugging in the workouts. And that's when it gets fun and exciting, and I'm really excited to share with you like specific workouts once 2019 starts rolling. I will share with you like specific workouts, whether it's mountain running, you know, fartlek running, whether it's strength training running. I have ideas for that for you guys. Or whether it's just simply getting on the track and doing, you know, speed work on the track. Like, that's important too. So anyway, that is how I like to do it. And then I also track my running, of course, through Strava. And by the way, let's connect down below if we haven't connected already on Strava. And then as backup, yes, I do it on a spreadsheet as well. So an electronic spreadsheet just to track things. But I first start here on paper so I have a general vision of what I'm looking at for 2019. I know I just covered a lot. I hope that made a little bit of sense. Please, please ask your questions down in the comments. And maybe better yet, if you have really specific questions, email me, because I'm not saying I can answer every single comment in detail. But if you find my email here on YouTube on the desktop version, I will respond to you. It might take me 2 or 3 days, but I will respond to you. And but I hope that made sense. All right, I love you guys. Keyword of the day. Blocks for training blocks. That's right, blocks like a square cube blocks. And the question of the day, what do your training blocks look like? How do you build them? What do they look like? Maybe even specifically in early 2019, like share as much as you'd, and maybe you don't have training blocks and that's okay, but maybe you're trying to build one. Maybe now because of this video, you're interested in building training blocks into your annual training schedule. So I'm so excited for this topic. Again, thank you for bearing with me. That was a lot to cover and I wish I could have talked all night, but I gotta let you guys eat your breakfast or go to bed. One of the two. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. Woo! See you tomorrow.